Good evening, everyone. I'd like to welcome you to the Board of School Trustees meeting here at Central High School, Tuesday, January 29th. Our first call is to do the Pledge of Allegiance. For everybody, please rise. Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
The call to order. We want to have the adoption of the agenda. D, under consent agenda, is there a motion for the minutes for the regular board meeting?
Motion to pass the minutes.
Motion by Trustee Winfield. Is there a second?
Second.
I'd like to add to the motion. If I may.
Trustee Rivera.
Testing. One, two. Testing. 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 Can you hear me? Testing.
Is it on?
Yeah. Oh, it's the battery's dead. I'm always
testing. Okay, testing. I'd like to amend the consent agenda by I want to add to this amendment that we do not at this time approve the claim docket and the personnel report, but go through it as to those items that we would like to extract from it.
Is the motion to amend by Trustee Rivera. Second?
Second.
Second by Trustee Hill. Discussion? Madam Secretary, could you please call roll?
Trustee Rivera.
Yay.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yeah.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Motion to amend has been approved.
Now, if we can, Mr. President, I'd like to go through some of these pieces in the claim docket.
Well, we need to approve the minutes and the distribution of the payroll.
Yes. Okay. I want to make a motion on the minutes for the regular board meeting, the distribution of payroll.
Second. And then motion to accept.
And motions to accept it.
Motion to accept the minutes of the regular board meeting, January 14, 2013, made by Trustee Rivera, seconded by Trustee Hill. Is there any discussion? Hearing done, roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes.
Nine.
Thank you.
Make a motion to accept the payroll.
Second.
It's a motion to accept the distribution of payroll by Trustee Winfield, seconded by Trustee Rivera. Is there any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item is claim docket.
Motion to amend the claim docket.
There's a motion to amend the claim docket by Trustee Rivera.
How do you want to?
Okay, I want to be able to go to those sections that we need to amend. Yes, I want to be able to remove items at this point. I want to remove on page 26 of the claim docket. That'll be the scientific learning. And then on page 34, that's in reference to it, which are all Title I, to move that from the docket until further study.
Are those the only two?
No, there's another one. We want to be able to remove the insurance, which is the self-insurance fund resolution from the docket.
Okay. Remove the payment.
Yeah, we want to remove the payment.
Transfer.
Of the transfer of funds, which is on page one of the pre-run under Fund 1100 self-insurance. And we want to be able to do a further study on this.
Okay, there's been a motion on the floor by Trustee Rivera. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that.
Second on the floor is discussion. Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes.
Motion to approve the amended claim docket.
It's a motion to amend to approve the amended claim docket by Trustee Rivera. Second. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that.
Second by Trustee Ramos. Is there a discussion?
I'd like to add to that motion if I can, Mr. President. Can I do that?
What's the question?
Since we removed the self-insurance from the claim docket, in
I think we need to get to that as part of the agenda.
Okay.
Is there a second to that motion?
Yes, Steph.
Yeah, there was a second on the motion.
For discussion.
Is there any other discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Claim docket's been approved as amended. The next item is the personnel report. Is there a motion to approve the personnel report?
President Gomez, I'd like to remove item 7 from that list. On page 1, under A.
There's a motion by Trustee Ramos to remove item 7 from the personnel report.
Okay. Second.
A second by Trustee Rivera. Is there any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
First of all, the personnel report on what? That area with those certified and non-certified?
Number 7, what was number 7?
Instructional coach.
Trustee Hill.
Sorry for the delay.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. With that item removed, is there a motion to approve the personnel report?
As amended?
As amended, thank you.
I'd like to make the motion that we accept it with the amendment.
There's a motion to accept by Trustee Rivera, is there a second?
I second that.
Second by Trustee Ramos, any discussion?
If you can approve, except you have an abstain on the dark.
Roll call, please. Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
I would like to abstain.
You can ask to the last.
Ask to the last.
You want to abstain as to Tiffany Hill?
Correct.
And you want to vote on the rest of them?
I would like to vote on the rest of them. However, I would like to abstain myself from Part D, extracurricular activities, number two, Tiffany Hill, because that's my daughter.
It's on page five, Ms. Rhonda.
On page five. Thank you, Trustee Frank Rivera.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Next item under consent agenda is five non-renewals. Is there a motion on the floor?
I'd like to make a motion.
Trustee Rivera?
We're talking about the non-renewal, correct, Mr. President?
Yes.
Okay. On behalf of the Board of School Trustees of the School City of East Chicago, I move to non-renew the administrative contracts of the following administrators effective the end of 12-13 school year. And there's a list that we have. And I further move that the Board President issue to the above-listed administrators written notice of the Board's decision to non-renew their administrative contract with the School City of East Chicago. That's the first motion.
There's a motion by Trustee Rivera on the floor. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that motion.
Second by Trustee Ramos. Discussion? A motion. Roll call, please.
Excuse me, sorry. Trustee Gomez, I need to abstain from voting on items 10 through 25 on the two-page list. On grounds that I was not present at that meeting.
Thank you. Roll call.
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
And Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Trustee Rivera, is there a second motion?
Yes, there's a second motion on the non-renewals for the second group. On behalf of the Board of School Trustees of the School City of East Chicago, I move to non-renew the administrative contracts of the following administrative effect at the end of 2012-2013 school year. I further move that the Board President issue to the above-listed administrators written notice of the Board's decision to non-renew their administrative contract with the School City of East Chicago.
There's a motion by Trustee Rivera. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that.
Second by Trustee Ramos. Is there any discussion? No discussion. Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, may I make a slight explanation of what the board has just done?
This shouldn't work.
Just basically for the information of the audience, what the board has done at this point, the board has not canceled any administrative contracts. What the board has done is made motions pursuant to statute to give notice of non-renewal. It does not mean anybody has been terminated. It does not mean that they cannot be rehired or cannot be given a contract later. The situation is that because of the way the Indiana statutes are written, you must give notice of non-renewal of an administrative contract no later than January 31st. So this board was operating under a deadline. The previous board had ordered notices of non-renewal to be issued to all administrators. This board has interviewed and heard all those administrators who asked to be heard by the board. The board is considering reorganization of the administrative staff, but to do so, they need time to evaluate, and the only way they can get that time is to give this notice of non-renewal, because if they do not by January 31st, contracts are automatically renewed at the end of the school year for next school year. So to give the board some leeway and some flexibility in what they want to do, they've basically given this notice of non-renewal, and the board will then consider who they want on their administrative team, and they'll conclude that by the end of the school year.
Thank you, Attorney Lesniak. Next item is item E, communications, announcements, recognitions. Number one, South Shore Leadership Youth for Community Engagement.
Yes, thank you, President Gomez. I'd like to share a few positives. I'd like to share a few positives this evening in communication, announcements, and recognitions. First of all, with the South Shore's Leadership Youth for Community Engagement, we have two students from Central High School who have been selected to participate in that. And those two students are Edith Espedia and Leslie Alanis. So we want to congratulate both of those students and wish them well. And I'd like to have Christian Flores, if he would, speak to the Sodexo Culinary Competition. Mr. Flores.
Good evening, Board President, members of the board. As presented to you in your packet, Sodexo, who is our food service partner, is currently conducting a Future Chefs Culinary Competition. The competition is focused around grades 3 through 6, and the intent behind the competition is to promote healthy eating habits for our students. The featured dish that will be presented is going to be a salad, and the judging will be based on the following criteria: originality of the product, kid friendliness, ease of preparation, and the best use of the featured ingredients, as you'll see in your packet. The leads have been submitted and they've been turned in by this past Friday, and currently we have 49 people that are willing to participate. We do have a distinguished panel of administrators that will be evaluating those recipes and submissions, and there will be one student picked from each school. The finalists will be formally invited to a culinary competition cook-off, which will take place on March 15, 2013 at Block Junior High, and the time for that event is yet to be determined. All finalists will receive a framed plaque, a recipe book of all finalists, a t-shirt and hat. And along with that evening, we will have a local press there. We'll be invited to take pictures of the students' creations, and parents and teachers can view and taste the final products during the reception portion of the event.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Also, this evening, we want to announce a grant that was received by Indiana University Bloomington that we partnered with, a math-science partnership grant that will support our teachers in developing curriculum and instructional strategies for math and science. Indiana University was awarded this three-year grant in the amount of $650,000, and we will be reaching out to our staff to participate in the professional development that they will be providing. This does incorporate professional development during the school year, support, and also some summer workshops for our teachers. You also have, we just received the announcement that we received a partnership grant with Notre Dame, an improving teacher quality grant. That amount, grant amount was in for $128,000, and that will support our partnership with Notre Dame to work with our science teachers at the high school on biology and integrated chemistry. So we are very fortunate to have developed those partnerships and to be working with those two universities. Last, under the communications and announcements, we have with us this evening some individuals from the African American Student Achievement Council. If they would come forward, we have Akinas Lewis, who is from Purdue University Calumet. She is with the Educational Talent Search. And also our own Pat Sims with Community and Schools. We are working with the African American Student Achievement Council to develop our young people to find better avenues to getting to college and career readiness. And also I see Lincoln Ellis has joined their group, so good evening, Mr. Ellis. Their PowerPoint hopefully is up front, thanks to Winston, and you have a copy of that in front of you, so I will turn the presentation over to them. Thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Lincoln Ellis. I am the chair of the African American Student Achievement Council. I'd like to reintroduce our team to you because we have a couple of people who joined us, but go ahead.
I'm Pat Sims from Communities and Schools.
Aquinas Lewis from Purdue University Calumet Educational Talent Search.
Kelly Chukwuberinfray from Educational Talent Search.
Denise Dillard with Methodist Hospitals.
I'm Laura Wen with Indiana Parenting Institute.
Thank you. A few years back, we came together and we looked at providing services that were specifically targeted at African American students in the 7th, 8th, and 9th grade. If you look upon, for the audience out here, I'm going to try to work this PowerPoint, some of our members up there. But if you look on the third slide within the packet in which you have, it kind of gives you some information in reference to the number of youngsters that we've served. And we've targeted this program at three different communities, Gary, Hammond, and East Chicago. And if you will note that the largest participation starting last year has been coming from East Chicago, and then we have our projection for 2013. We will be having Reality University on February the 8th at Purdue Calumet, where we'll be bringing in a little over 300 young people from those respective communities. And we're very happy to say that we've been able to get a significant number of young people coming from East Chicago. If you look at the next slide, it provides you information in reference to the breakout of where those young people are coming from the East Chicago. And so, as you see right now, we're projecting 169 young people come from East Chicago on February the 8th to participate with us at Reality U. The first year we had 77, then we doubled that number in 2012 to 141, and a lot of that is due to the support that we've received, tremendous support from Foundations of East Chicago that has became a key sponsor for this event for us. In addition to this event that we have here, the various different organizations that participate with us provide an array of services throughout the school year for the youngsters. And we find organizations like Communities in School, like the Educational Talent Search, as well as Boys and Girls Club, providing day-to-day programs, but we're specifically tracking these young people. And you'll see on the next slide that we really do emphasize college preparation. Our intent of this program is not for our young people just to progress through school, not just graduate from high school, not just enroll in college, but also to graduate from college. We've been teaching programming specifically for our young people with a program called Know How to Go, which has been approved by the state of Indiana, that is a college preparation program. We're making sure that the kids learn the Common Core standards, and we want to prepare them for the SAT, ND, ACT testing. And so we have a heavy emphasis in those particular areas. Our goals, as you can see on the next slide, begins to share with you that we want to increase the number of 7th, 8th, and 9th grader students who are promoted and go on and progress. We want to increase the number of African Americans that enter high school. We want to increase the number of African American students who obtain their high school diploma, increase the number of African American students that graduate and go on to college, as well as those that graduate from college. It is a strong effort of our organization. What are we asking you to do? We wanted to come and share with you what we've been doing for the past 3 years, and we're asking you to support us. And we've received tremendous support in the past years from East Chicago schools. We want you to designate someone that will be a member of the African American Student Achievement. You designate a person, and we've had an opportunity to talk to Superintendent Harding, who lent his support, but we're asking you as a board that you would support our efforts by naming someone that would represent you on the school, on the African American Student Achievement Council. In the past, you've provided transportation to some of the activities and specifically to our Reality U. And Reality U is an outstanding event, and I'm going to ask Pat to kind of give you a background on Reality U.
Reality U is an initiative that students come to. It's actually our capstone event. Based on all of the activities the students participate in during the year, they're then invited to Reality University, where they have an opportunity to participate in college preparatory activities, workshops, and even hear great keynote speakers. This year we have Dr. Chandra Gill. So we even invite you to come out and just come and get a snippet of that event this year.
Thank you. The other thing that we're asking you to do in order to be able to track these young people, make sure that they're enrolling in the programs, getting the assistance, that we're going to be asking that you share data with us in reference to the young people's attendance. We have a number of community-based organizations that will be willing to work with you if those young people are not attending school. We want to emphasize the importance of going to school. We want to emphasize the importance of their behavior. And so we're setting up the systems and the mechanisms to be able to track that. You also have a document in your hand. I believe that you received the document. It kind of gives you some ideas. We're actually surveying, looking at the impact. That's something that we began last year, and we intend to look at the impact, and we have, as you've seen, outcomes that we anticipate our young people reaching in this program. As I said, this program would not have been possible if it had not been for the support of our major funder, which is Foundations of East Chicago, Fifth Third Bank, Barton Gary Foundation, and Ameristar. I also like to point out that our lead agency in this is Purdue Calumet. And Regina Biddings, who is a product of East Chicago Schools, she unfortunately could not be with us tonight, but she has been heading up this, and she's one of the original founders of this, this effort. And so we're here to take any questions or give you any clarity of anything in which we may have discussed.
Are there any questions by the board members?
No, just keep up the good work.
Thank you.
I do have one item I'd like to say. I see Denise Dillard. I've worked with her on several programs in the past, and if she's on board, it's definitely a good program, so I support it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Larson to complete your report.
Yes, sir. Are we moving on to business, Mr. Gomez?
Yes.
Okay. You have in your packets, members of the board, the request for professional development, and we are looking for a motion for approval for that information.
Board, I'd like to address the board members and mention to them that there is a recommendation on the floor for approval of professional development request.
President Gomez, there are a few items I'd like to pull off of these professional development. The first item, attendance to the 2013 IASBO Treasurer's Workshop 4-part series. The third item, building a school corporation's annual budget, a 4-part seminar series. Those are the only two items I'd like to pull.
Okay, thank you. There's a motion by Trustee Ramos to remove items 1 and 3. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Trustee Hill. Is there any discussion? On the motion to remove items 1 and 3 from the recommendation for professional development, can I have a roll call, please?
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes.
President Gomez, I'd like to make a motion to accept the professional development as amended with the removal of items 1 through 3. Or 1 and 3.
1 and 3. Thank you. There's a motion by Trustee Ramos.
Second.
On the floor to approve the amended professional development request, seconded by Trustee Rivera.
All right. Second.
Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Next item is recommendations for approval of 2012 appropriation transfer resolution. Laura Hubinger.
President Gomez, I'd like to make a motion to go ahead and pass this appropriations transfer resolution.
Second.
There's a motion by Trustee Rivera, seconded by Trustee Rodriguez. Is there a discussion? Ms. Hubinger, do you want to go through this with us?
I certainly can explain the purpose of that if you have a question of this type of resolution. Every year I come to the board for the closing out purpose with our general fund and transportation fund. With the programs, you approve at budget time the appropriations that are allotted by program. As expenses are occurring throughout the year, there are times where others you spend more and in other areas you spend less. So according to the State Board of Accounts, I'm required to transfer those appropriations within each fund individually to cover those expenses. In general fund, the transfers are presented to you by program on the resolution. Your transportation is also handled that way as well.
Thank you. Roll call.
Yes. Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Next item is item three, recommendation for approval of self-insurance fund resolution.
Mr. President.
Trustee Rodriguez.
I'd like to make a motion to defer consideration to the next board meeting.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Trustee Rivera. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hale.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item, recommendation for approval of donation to Central High School Extracurricular Club. Is there a motion to accept that?
I motion to accept.
Motion to accept recommendation for approval of donation to Central High School Extracurricular Club by Trustee Winfield. Second.
Second.
Second by Trustee Hill. Discussion. Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item, recommendation for approval of crafts and Teamster agreement.
Mr. President.
Trustee Rodriguez.
I'll make a motion to accept recommendation for approvals. Stir cycle contract.
No, run.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Run.
The recommendation for approval of craft and Teamsters agreement. Sorry.
I'll second that.
Second, I'm sorry, motion by Trustee Rodriguez, second by Trustee Rivera. Is there any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item, recommendation for approval, Stericycle contracts.
I'd like to make a motion, Mr. President, that we approve this Stericycle contract.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Rivera, seconded by Trustee Rodriguez. Discussion?
Yes. Stericycle by Christian Flores. Can you give us a little objective or overview of this particular?
Contract is a contract that handles our bio waste and hazards in the school buildings. So basically what we did is we renegotiated our pricing with the companies. It's not a new contract, it's just renegotiated contract or pricing and frequency of pickups. So in the past, there was no fluency in how those pickups were done or the actual costs that were being charged. So we just got together with them and they itemized each bill and made it similar to each location. So as you'll see, there's a pretty significant cost reduction that we'll see as a result of this.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Christian.
Yes.
Do you have an estimated budget in terms of what how much you're saving for this?
Based on the figures that have been presented, it's about a $33,000 savings annually. Any other questions?
Any further questions?
You say that was a $33,000?
$33,000, yes.
Could we see that in writing?
You have it in your packet.
Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item is recommendation for 2013 regular board meetings. I think all board members received a copy of the schedule for the board meeting considerations. There were four options. Options A, B, C, and D. Is there a motion to?
Yes, Mr. President, I'd like to make a motion on option C, which is.
There's a motion to approve option C as the board meeting schedule for 2013. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that motion.
Second by Trustee Ramos. Any discussion?
Mr. President, can you explain option C so that way everyone is very clear with it?
Could you repeat yourself, please?
If you can explain option C for us to make sure that everyone's clear with that in terms of the audience. Do we have option C? Because I don't have my option C, but I remember it was option C.
Option C is a Tuesday-Thursday meeting split schedule. So on, for example, in February, February 12th is a Tuesday. The following meeting will be held on a Thursday, on February 28th. Likewise, in March, the first meeting will be on a Tuesday, the 12th, and the second meeting will be on a Thursday, on the 28th.
Okay, thank you.
Are you okay with that?
Yes.
All meetings will be posted on the EC school website for the public knowledge.
We'll ask Mr. Harding to post these as soon as they've been approved by the board. Any other discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Yes. Next item is, excuse me, Next item is 2013 school board committees selection. I'd like to make an announcement of those committees. The committees for 2013 will be finance, buildings, ground and maintenance, security and safety, arts, athletics, technology, curriculum, and transportation. The members will be named at a later date. I'd also like to appoint Stacy Winfield to the committee for the group to just address this, the ASAC. Trustee Winfield will be on that, the board representative to that organization. Under board committees, there's also consideration for Board of Finance for 2013. Is there a motion on the floor?
I'd like to make a motion, President Gomez, to accept the committee selections, board committee selections.
Second.
Motion to accept the committee selections by Trustee Ramos, seconded by Trustee Morris. Roll call, please. Second by Trustee Morris.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. In addition to the board committee selections, there's also a Board of Finance that will be established by state law. We need to do this by the end of this month. Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
I need you to address the issue of the Board of Finance.
I move that the President, the Secretary, and the Treasurer be appointed for the Board of Finance in those respective positions.
It's a motion by Trustee Rivera on the floor for the Board of Finance for 2013. Is there a second?
I'd like to second that.
Second by Trustee Ramos. Any discussion? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item is board, excuse me, board compensation.
Mr. President.
If I might interrupt for a minute. If the members that have just been selected to the Board of Finance can approve the depositories that have been used by the school system and listed, that's one of the functions of the Board of Finance, is to approve those depositories. So if the three members who've been appointed to the board, if someone would make a motion to approve the depositories and have it seconded and have those three members vote on.
I'd like to make that motion.
It's up to them.
Sorry.
I mean, I'd like to make an amendment
to approve the deposit.
To approve the deposit.
Second.
Okay. Need a vote from the three of you.
Vote.
Roll call.
It's just you three. Jesse.
Trustee Rivera.
No. It'll be just the three that we voted for. That'll be Terrence.
Trustee Perez.
Just the three.
Trustee Hill will be the first vote, Trustee Winfield the second, and I'll be the third vote. Just roll call on us three.
Okay. Trustee Hill.
And who else? It's three.
No, it's Winfield.
Me. It's for me.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
And then Chairman Gomez?
Yes. Let's
see. No.
Ms. Hubinger, do you have to be the third vote?
Laura Hubinger.
Yes.
Thank you. Next item is board compensation. Is there a motion to accept the board compensation resolution?
Mr. President, let me first explain what the resolution is. The resolution is compensation for this board, and it's based on the statutes and the laws of the state of Indiana. The resolution would states that the annual salary of each member of the Board of Trustees is $2,000 per year. That is the maximum allowed by state law. You are also to receive a per diem of $112 per meeting of the Board of Trustees, plus $62 per meeting of all committees, all as permitted and allowed by the Indiana statutes and laws. Those are the maximum per diems allowed in the state of Indiana.
Is there a motion to approve the resolution for board compensation?
Yes, Mr. President, I'd like to make that motion.
Second.
It's a motion to approve the board compensation resolution by Trustee Rivera, seconded by Trustee Rodriguez. Questions? Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item is legal contract. The motion to accept the legal contract for services to the Board of Trustees.
I make a motion.
Accept. Oh.
Trustee
motion to accept
Rodriguez.
I second that.
And I'm sorry, who's the second?
Joe.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Trustee Hill's motion.
I make a motion. He second.
Is there any discussion? Roll call.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes.
Mr. President, if I can, let me explain what that contract is. That's my contract. Basically, the contract is for my services as general counsel to the board. The compensation is $5,000 per month beginning in February of 2013, plus $150 an hour for each hour in excess of 33 hours per month. The month of January will be billed strictly at $150 per hour. There's a 30-day termination clause. The board can terminate my contract, or I can terminate my contract within 30 days' notice.
Thank you. Is there a roll call, please?
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
I believe we did. I think we just did that.
Did you? I'm sorry.
We did that. The legal contract.
Sorry.
I think we voted on this information.
That's all right.
Do it twice.
My apologies. Next item is video contract. We've not had time to review this contract, and I'm just going to ask if the board can make a motion to withdraw this contract for now.
Mr. President?
Yes.
I make a motion to postpone it.
It's a motion to pull the video contract at this meeting and schedule it for the next meeting by Trustee Rodriguez. Second.
Second.
Second by Trustee Morris. Discussion. Roll call.
Wait a minute. Discussion. I'm sorry. You went too fast for me on the discussion part.
Yeah.
On this video contract, what is this video contract?
Video services that are provided to the board for recording of the regular public meetings.
Okay. We can hold off on that. Okay. Yes, we'll postpone it to the next meeting. Okay. Just so I'll make sure. Thank you.
Okay. Roll call, please.
Trustee Rivera.
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez.
Yes.
Trustee Hill.
Yes.
Trustee Winfield.
Yes.
Trustee Morris.
Yes.
Trustee Monroe.
Yes.
Trustee Perez.
Yes.
Trustee Ramos.
Yes.
Chairman Gomez.
Yes. Next item is public forum.
Excuse me, Mr. President.
Sorry, yes.
Yeah, may I make a motion to amend the agenda for an add-on?
Trustee Hill, would you like to add on?
Yes, I make a motion to hire a DLW Public Promotions as a legislator and a policy consultant.
Yeah, Mr. President, I'm sorry, but the board has already adopted the agenda at the beginning of the meeting. And if you were, you know, that's the time to have it amended. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And approve the agenda.
Okay.
The next item on the agenda, is item G, public forum. We'll ask everybody to keep your comments to 3 minutes or less. Be respectful, no personal attacks, and the board would like to hear your comments. We will not respond. We will just be here to listen to your comments and respond to you at a later date and time. I'll turn this over to Trustee Winfield to do a roll call of speakers.
Carl Donnie.
My name is Carl Dolan, Jr. I reside at 4720 Ivy Street here in East Chicago. I say greetings to the Chicago School Board, Superintendent Harding, and all employees of the school city, as well as the citizens of East Chicago. I'm not here to criticize this board, for I feel that you have a positive agenda for the future of this city and its school. I came here to commend your courage in these confusing times and commend all those who are involved and ran for this office. With that said, I hope you will make positive contributions to the daunting tasks you have before you, the many volatile problems that face all of us, from drugs, bullying, low grades, and numerous school problems. I hope you will all work as one unit. Your wise decisions making can make a great impact in resolving these difficult issues which we are all currently facing. All students and employees need to be fully treated, not prejudiced against, falsely accused, and need to be justly heard to maintain the integrity as well as and promote the betterment of our schools. We must address the students' troubles to keep our schools safe and ensure their future. Perhaps to accomplish this means an advisory board can be created to assist in this endeavor. This board can be comprised of students, board members, parents, and those in the schools that will qualify and care. We must remember, teachers did not ask to be policemen. Students want to be educated, and administrators get paid to make sure that everyone is protected to make our schools the very best. We have the capability with this new board. It is now time to capture what is ours for the future of our schools and community. A few more comments, but I ran out of time, so thank you very much.
Thank you.
Very good.
Iris Brucey.
We have a sheet that we would like to pass out to the board. Is that okay?
Sure.
And I'll begin. This resolution regarding Superintendent Michael Harding. The Chicago Federation of Teachers Local AFT 511 has determined that Superintendent Michael Harding has substantially decreased the educational opportunities of the children of East Chicago, promoting substandard education by some of these items that I will discuss. The graduation rates have been questionable since the superintendent has been in East Chicago, due largely to the implementation of the credit recovery and there not being any consistency in control over how, when, where, and to whom the exams were taken by. Communication with teachers is completely inadequate. Emails go unanswered, unaddressed, urgencies, and the superintendent is rarely seen.
We cannot use anybody's name.
Okay.
You can say superintendent, but not the names.
Okay. Thank you. All right, and superintendent is rarely being seen in our schools. The superintendent has not lived up to the strategic plan of attracting and maintaining a highly motivated workforce. Teachers' income has continued to decrease related to work time, and insurance costs have gone up, but the superintendent pays only a dollar a year. The quality of educational programs has decreased with the Fast Forward, which lacks independent data for its effectiveness, and the Math Navigator. Meanwhile, there have been huge increases in the administrator salaries under the superintendent, primarily for individuals from Michigan City. Under this superintendent, the number of administrators has increased greatly. increasing the administrator-to-student ratio. An expensive 12-page glossy advertisement was sent to all the homes in East Chicago in the spring of 2012 when teachers were often unable to get paper for our copies. The Foundation of East Chicago has placed the school city of East Chicago on suspension. There are questions about what efforts the superintendent has made to remove the suspension. The school district has been unable to secure valuable grants to provide essential extracurricular activities for our students. And essential programs like the music programs where we had instruments for our students have also decreased. Band was eliminated. Chorus classes were cut in half at Central. The choir extracurricular stipend was eliminated without board approval, hurting this important educational opportunity for high school students. We are asking that the board, our new board that was elected, please meet with the union and try to resolve some of these issues. I did hear that you are forming new committees, and we're hoping that the teachers who are in the schools and work with the students every day, we hope that you invite us in to also work with you. Thank you.
Thank you. Byron Duke Florence.
Good evening, Mr. President, board members. Bear with me. I'm going to go about 30 seconds over my 3 minutes. I already know that. So bear with me. But first of all, I'd like to congratulate you for at least looking into that situation with the non-renewal of those administrators' contracts. And I think you're doing an excellent job off the bat. But one thing I do need to let you know, again, the state of Indiana is putting this school board under the gun, and it's just catching everybody off guard. And the reason I say that, because they have this school choice proponents now. You know, they believe that to improve the quality and education of students, you know, they want to get into this competitiveness so the students can have an opportunity in the global market. And I can appreciate that. And families must be empowered to give their kids the best quality education money can buy. And the reason I say that, with this new voucher program, and I don't know if you guys are aware of it, the House Bill 1003, the voucher program now is $5,500 per student. Next year is going to go up to $6,500 per student. And if you think it ain't going to affect the students here, watch out. And the reason I say that, now the voucher program hits kids in kindergarten. So when your child is eligible in kindergarten, they can start getting $5,500 a year to go to any school they want. And don't think it's going to take away from the public schools. Let me give you a figure that will automatically let you know that they intend on pushing this program all the way through. The percentage of people on this program, 52% of them are white, 20% are black, and 19% are Hispanic. We got a problem. I'm going to go off the chain a little bit, just simply to say, I happen to run into John Aguilera coming into this building. What this school board is going to have to do, believe me, you're going to have to do it. At some point, you're going to need to get a consultant or a lobbyist to represent this board in Indianapolis. And John has all those qualities that you're looking for. He just happened to pop up. Another thing I want to go over is that I went on the school city website. And I was astounded of what the school city is actually offering. I mean, they're offering some programs that can actually pull us out of some of these problems we're having. And I don't know if we'll utilize them. My problem is, how do you get in touch with the parents to let them utilize the program? We're getting failing grades, but I'm going to use a non-statistical point real quick, that those students that are failing those parents are not participating in these programs.
We can't let you do that, because if you do that, then everybody else...
I understand, Mr. Hill.
That's not fair.
I just wanted to address one this last thing, and it pertains...
Save for next week, please. Because we start now, we're going to have to let everybody do that. We want to treat everybody fair.
I understand. Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Some of these things I mentioned, I think you guys need to go into automatically.
Thank you very much, Mr. Florence.
Emily Panter.
Good evening. My name is Emily Pancheri. I'm one of the teachers at Franklin Academy. My problem, concern, is that I have a copy of my settlement from the School City of East Chicago when they fired me illegally 2 years ago. They fired me illegally. They hired in unlicensed, less qualified teachers. I fought for my job, and I won. We were days away from arbitration, and they simply offered me a job. I am a licensed history teacher. They gave me a job, not my job, a job. They put me at Franklin Academy Elementary School. I am not licensed in that area. This is ridiculous. This is not part of my settlement agreement. The school city has not lived up to my settlement. This was all supposed to be retroactive from my original hire date. My salary is not reflective, nor are my sick days. Tonight, you guys approved a brand new social studies teacher. I'd like to know why. I have it right here. This person is going to be working at Central High School. I was never given the opportunity to properly apply for that job. Somebody fell asleep. I have the emails here to Human Resources, and they denied me. Nobody can give me an answer. They have failed to live up to their agreement. These positions are available, and no one is able to help me. But I have my agreement. I have the emails from Human Resources. A teacher left. An unlicensed person was hired in. I wasn't even allowed to apply. I'd like to know why. Because you know what? What Michael Harding has done to me is ridiculous.
Louis Segura.
I got it. We got it.
Yes.
Good evening, board members. My name is Luis Segura, and I am the culinary arts instructor here at East Chicago Central. Last summer, while on summer break, I was contacted by my coworker regarding a matter saying that I was going to be put on a part-time status due to the fact that there were not enough students to fill up my entire class schedule, which, as you know, was never board approved. The reason being was that students had to make up math and English classes. Last year, I had a total of 75 students. So beginning this year, I expected maybe to have 50, 60 students. In August, I was given my class roster, and to my surprise, I had a total of 120 students. A class like mine, where students have to be well supervised, should have a limit of 15 students for safety reasons. Students need to be well supervised when handling sharp knives, fire, and cooking equipment. I have up to 25 students in some of my classes. Another problem I have is that I'm not being paid for my fifth hour class, but they want me to be at work and justify not paying me while being at work the entire day. I feel like I am being treated unfairly. I have always been a team player and have gone above and beyond, not only for my students, but also for the administrators that are treating me and my coworkers so unfairly. I live in East Chicago, and I'm a product of East Chicago, and for me to be treated this way is unjust. The only reason I'm here is to give back to the students here in East Chicago. Nothing in my culinary career has ever been more rewarding than being a positive influence on the students that call Central High home. Seeing someone like myself that lives in East Chicago gives them hope that they too can become whatever they so desire. So I ask you to put this matter behind me, pay me what I deserve, and let me focus on the students. Thank you very much.
Larry Regan.
Thank you.
Good evening, Chairman and Board of Trustees. My name is Larry Regan. I am the Vice President of Teamsters Local 142 in Gary, Indiana, and I want to thank the board for approving our contract with the school corporation. And we'll be looking forward to working with the Board of Trustees and the school corporation. Thank you very much.
Bert Flores.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the board, and kudos to Trustees Ramos and Rivera. Thank you on the good catches. Let's go back last year before November's election at a little place called Post 369. Each and every one of you promised the teachers and unions better conditions, and especially respect. You also promised to get rid of our current superintendent. Last school board meeting, you were told about a $3 million debt. As a community leader who has been coming to these meetings for over 2.5 years, I can provide you with a list of names and positions and salaries of created positions. Some of these are not certified administrators, but they're paid as administrators. If you need to cut from this budget, let's start there. You all can remember how the schools used to be before our current administration. Start honoring your promises to the people and to the children. Don't take away anything that would help them. Start with the people who are hurting. Like all of these workshops and things that they do or use to better themselves so they can put on their resumes whenever they leave here. All right. Also, can we rotate these meetings to all the district schools so local issues can be addressed? I've provided some of the board members with copies of a little ordinance that's going on where we're having a little issue. And we have people that are breaking these ordinances. I've also provided things of these vehicles to ECPD. Thanks to for some not so favorable officers. Our plea has been ignored, and the safety issue at McKinley has escalated. Like today, a vehicle driving down a one-way and parking in a slot one-way. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't want to do the job, let's get someone who will.
Lali Rosala.
Good evening, board members. My name is Lali Rosala. I'm a school counselor at Black Junior High. I come to you with a concern there about the LEP students, the limited English proficient students. Once counselors were reinstated, I returned to Black the last week of November. I learned quickly that our LEP students were hurting a little bit, meaning they weren't getting support that they should be getting. We have a population there of about 90 students who are not being serviced as they should be. LEP was formerly known as TESOL students in the past. Let me give you a brief rundown of what LEP is. The students whose language is not English, they're flagged either from a 1 to a 5, 1 being they have very limited reading and writing skills, and a 5 being obviously very fluent. We have 67 students out of those 90 who are level 1 to 4. That's quite high students who aren't proficient, who aren't fluent. So they need that support. Again, that number 67 out of 90 who are not level 5s and not fluent. So I tried to put support in when I get there. Long story short, I realized shortly that there was no ESL specialist there, but I was told that there was a posting, and there sure indeed was. It was a job posting for an ESL specialist, but that no one applied. I was told no one applied, so there was kind of a fill-in teacher. Well, I realized tonight on the personnel report that fill-in teacher who was running to Black, she resigned. So now we are back to having nobody. So I'm kind of taking that position, trying to get support in for these students and place them where, you know, the support that needs to be placed. I realize the guidance counselor's duty is to ensure all students are receiving the best academic route we can provide. I also found that there were two Spanish-speaking paraprofessionals who were there, but they're running fast-forward labs. I don't think we have fast-forward anymore. So when I inquired what each para was doing in these fast-forward labs, they reported the children were reporting to this classroom going on Compass Odyssey. Compass Odyssey is not a state curriculum course. 300 kids are currently sitting in these labs 1 hour a day, 5 days a week, not learning a whole lot on Compass. I understand, and it's no fault to the principal, I want to make that clear, that when Fast Forward was taken away, they were already rolling in their school year. They already had those labs set up. So I understand that it was just easier to put in Compass Odyssey there. But we're just servicing 300 kids a day. I took on the appropriate measures, met with Ms. Holland, who's the director of LEP, and she agreed that support for these students should have been in place already. We got together, presented a plan of action, emailed it to our principal. In the end, we got a thank you for your input, it will be considered, and the paras will remain in their current positions. I mean, I couldn't utilize those paras who were Spanish speaking. There was two of them. I was additionally told to not take any more directives from Ms. Holland in the future. I'm confused. Isn't she the director? Thank you.
Wayne Josby.
Wayne Josby.
Chairman Gomez and the rest of the school board members, I congratulate you, and I'm looking forward to working with you as far to better the students of East Chicago. I'm here to talk about the no-grade policy. As we know, with anything new, there's some unintended consequences. With the no-grade policy that's in effect for the third year, teachers have noticed a lack of complacency from the students. Students have no sense of urgency in getting their classroom assignments in. Students have got so bold to tell teachers that we're not worried about passing. You have to give us a credit recovery. Now, is this preparing the students for college? Those of you that know me, those of you that have worked with me, I've had many people out in the audience, I've had their children. As science department chair, I really, really fear that we are setting them up to fail in college. Example, when my students were close to passing the course, they would bust their rear ends to get at least a D. All of us know we're not good at everything. If I had to worry about an art grade and getting a C in art, I'd still be in high school, because my version of drawing a person is a circle with five sticks. But my teacher seen that I tried and I busted my rear end to improve. I'm a science teacher. I'm department chair. I've had several wonderful students come out of East Chicago and go on to bigger and better lives. And I'm proud of that. I'm more proud of the students they have taught. When the students were close to a D, they were working, they were busting, they want to succeed. And the second semester, guess what? Their grades improved even to B's and A's. Why? They hustled. They learned better study habits. We helped them. Now when the students are close to a D, what would have been a D, 60%, they sit back in the classroom. They become problem children. Why? Because there's no sense of goal. There's no sense of fulfillment for them. They realize they're so far away from a C that they don't want to do anything. A lack of assignments being turned in is a big reason that we have no grade. Why? Because the students have no sense of urgency anymore. They're being told, and they have been conditioned in the past 3 years, that we have to get a recovery project. Go tell that to your supervisors. Tell that to your college professors. I know our students are much better than that. We got a wonderful set of students. You can see that with our Science Olympiad teams over the years. Thank you very much.
Kathy Wojas.
Hello, Kathy Wojas. I have to say congratulations to all of you. Hope we can do good sticking all together for the kids, the students of East Chicago. I don't know, truthfully, if that teacher was for or against an OD. All I know is I'm against it. My daughter's a senior this year, and I have seniors in my house every weekend because I'd rather them come to my house than my daughter be out not knowing where she's at. So I'll buy them pieces or whatever, and I do talk to them. A lot of them don't got dads. A lot of them, their mothers don't talk to them, or they're working, or crackheads, whatever the problem is. I'm like everybody's mother in my house. This no D thing, yeah, they're probably not turning in their homework and stressing them. They hate credit recovery. I don't know any of the kids I talk to like that credit recovery. These kids feel they're victims. There's no other school in Indiana that has this law, or policy, I should say, because the state didn't even provide this. The superintendent, to me, was on probation and tried to prove, hey, yeah, I'll come out of probation, and I'll also show my opinion. To me, he was thinking, he'll show the state, we'll come out of probation and have our school ABC school. Like I said, our kids are being victim. They're stressed out. I know a girl that's 2 credits short. She's not even finishing school. She's quitting school because our kids have been here 12 years. Our kids, like Duke said, could have went with the vouchers. They could have went to choice schools, whatever. But they stood with us for 12 years. And there's so many of them stressed out on getting these 2 or 3 credits. The teachers should know the kids that are screwed. Messing around in class, not trying, well, good, get them out of class. The kids that are struggling, like I can give credit to Mr. Webster, my daughter's math teacher. When the kids were struggling there, he kept like a handful of them after school for like 3 or 4 days and got them up to a C from their D plus. And everybody got D's in school, okay? We don't want our kids going to college. I don't care what school you go to, I don't care who the person is. If you're struggling, a D plus is better. Not straight D's, I'm not saying that, but the kids will go to college, leave their friends, and learn. They got to struggle and settle for that ABC and get through college. I think, truthfully, you guys, all the parents and teachers come and talk to you guys, and you guys represent the students. I think the best idea would be is why don't you have an assembly, all you school board members with the students or just the seniors, and ask the students, why in the heck are you failing? You know, why aren't you coming to school? Find out what their problem is. Maybe there's more to it than the teachers or anybody else know. And I also think you ought to evaluate some of the math or English teachers' percentage of students that are flunking. If there's 50, if the majority of math students are the ones not getting the credit, why don't you check and see the math teacher if it's 50, 60% of the kids flunking, it's not always the student or the parent. Okay, I'm done. Thank you, and congratulations again. Please, guys, like I said, we don't have all year. We got 4 months before the kids graduate. Please get on this fast. Thank you.
Carlisle Edwards.
Can we get the monitors on the stage turned up? Because I'm hearing the speakers in the back, but I'm not hearing these monitors up on stage.
Good evening. My name is Carlisle Edwards. I reside at 532 Reagan Place. First of all, and I've already emailed a few of this on this, I would like to recommend that our school board create a resolution to the state legislature education subcommittee and to the representatives, especially those two that represent our area. And the reason for that is the following. Indiana voters overwhelmingly chose Democratic Glenda Ritz in November's election over Tony Bennett and his so-called school reform. However, the State House is now entertaining two bills as political retribution to diminish her authority as the duly elected superintendent of public instruction. We need to support our students, our teachers, and our duly elected superintendent by calling and writing to our representatives, especially those of our friends and whoever who represent, who live in those areas controlled by the Republicans, because the Republicans right now have enough votes to be able to pass this without. House Bill 1251 will strip the requirement that at least four of the 10 members of the State Board of Education be licensed educators. In other words, you don't even have to have a background in education to be able to serve on the Board of Education. That's wrong. Secondly, they're also going to scrap the requirement that no more than six people are from the same political party. What this basically means is that voices of experience will be gone. Voices of dissent, gone. Voices of bipartisanship, gone. In other words, whatever they want to do, they'll do. House Bill 1309 will also force the Board of Education to elect a vice chairperson, which will actually, in essence, create a 2-to-1 vote against Glenda Ritz or any subsequent superintendent. So there's another voice that'll be gone, because she'll be constantly overruled. Next item, I want to congratulate you guys on having a well-done meeting tonight. Y'all had a rocky start last time. Last time, you offered slivers of hope and some thoughts of, oh my God, another 4 years of this? I want to commend you for having a well-run meeting tonight, but keeping one thing foremost in your minds. You need to support our teachers, such as Emily Panteri, Luis Segura, and all the rest. If you don't support them...
Mr. Chairman, I'm going to refrain from announcing names, okay? Thank you.
I'm only announcing them because they were already up here speaking. You need to support our teachers' aides, and our students. And I'll be speaking again.
All right, thank you.
Reggie Tisdale.
Good evening, President Gomez, Vice President Hill, esteemed members of the School Board of Trustees. My name is Reggie Tisdale. I live at 4801 Walsh. I'm a teacher at Carrigash Elementary, and I work for the Teachers Union as the Working Conditions Chairman, the Grievance Chairman. My work with the union basically is comprised of dealing with the concerns, the legal issues that teachers may face, and their daily working conditions in schools. Our whole mission, we strive to work towards the best working conditions for teachers, not for selfish reasons. The best working conditions for teachers are basically and outright the best learning environments for children. You provide the best daily working conditions for teachers to teach under. That's the best learning environment for children. I tell you what, the past 2 years, I would hesitate to ever go to a board meeting because it was just confusing. It was, it just seemed very strange. I've been so impressed tonight with the strength and unity you've shown. It's extremely impressive and very optimistic for the next 4 years. Teachers, when they come to me for years, they want to be involved. They want to, you know, it's exciting. You mentioned committees. Oh, my goodness. Please include teachers in committees. They want to be involved. We work every day, teachers, social workers, and counselors, with these children. We know what needs to be done to fix the schools, yet we've not been included. Oh, yeah, every once in a while, we're on a dog and pony committee. Next thing we know, something else is done. You know, I'm not going to mention recent ones, which I should, but I'm not going to tonight. Okay, involve us, please. They beg for you to become involved in our schools. They want to see you in the hallways. They want to see you talking to principals. They want you to come to our classrooms. Come come to Cary, gosh, every day. I work with 150 wonderful kids on a daily basis. I can use some help, too. Wonderful kids. I've got aspiring Olympic athletes. Yet there's nothing in the elementary schools that support their extracurricular. Nothing. Okay? It's incredible what we have there. And it's been that way too bad for years. And teachers are really concerned. What school corporation gets rated F by the IDOE the last 3 years? East Chicago, we're the only one. What manager down the street at McDonald's would get one F for a year and keep his job or her job? None. We need your help. We need your engagement. I beg you. I mean, we could save our schools. We lost 600 kids underneath this administration. 600 kids. How do you explain that away? There's a lot of reasons, but if you're a former committee to address that, we can work on that. I heard a lot of nice committee names. We need a curriculum committee, a purchasing committee, so suspect things aren't purchased and wasted. I'd also like to welcome back Mr. Lesniak. Mr. Lesniak.
Just like everyone else.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate that. Thank you. We'll be here next time, so announce it.
Tierra Mobley.
Good evening, school board members, as well as community and staff. My name is Tierra Mobley. I'm currently a paraprofessional at Franklin Academy. I have been employed with the district for 5 years. I stand before you to discuss a matter concerning myself. There was a case manager position posted on the school website. I inquired about it to our HR director as far as what were the requirements, because I hold a bachelor's degree in psychology, as well as I furthered my education by going to school for teaching while employed for the school district. But so I inquired about the requirements. I was sent back a list of the requirements concerning the position. And once I looked over the requirements, I expressed my interest to the HR director as well as the student services director. I was granted an opportunity for an interview on Friday, January 25th at 1 p.m. However, that interview did not happen. I was told the day before that my interview was canceled because the district is no longer looking to hire to fill that position at the time. I asked why, and I was told that it was due to budgetary restraints. So my concern is, if there wasn't any funding for that position, why was it posted in the first place? Why was it posted for 2 weeks, and why is it still posted as of today? So I was really excited and looking forward to the interview because I am, like he mentioned, I'm a product of East Chicago as well as the schools, and I love working with the children, and I want to continue to work with the children and show them that regardless of where you're from, you can still make it. So I just wanted to inform you so that maybe you can look into the matter. Also, I have a suggestion of maybe many people in my position, for example, as a paraprofessional, many of us do have bachelor's degrees and master's and whatever else. So maybe as internal employees, we can have the opportunity to apply for positions before it is offered to external employees, because we are in the district and we are working with the children every day. Thank you.
This evening's meeting. The next item is the date and time of the next meeting, which will be February 12th at 6 p.m. at Lincoln School.
February 12th.
Is there a motion for adjournment?
A motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn, second by Trustee Morris. Roll call.
Trustee
Tiara?
Yes.
Trustee Rodriguez?
Yes.
Trustee Hill?
Yes.
Trustee Winfield?
Yes.
Trustee Morris?
Yes.
Trustee Monroe?
Yes.
Trustee Perez?
Yes.
Trustee Ramos?
Yes.
Chairman Gomez?
Yes.